Shall we run the track?
I'll just start going for some takes. You never know, just in case there's some magic.
You need somebody who likes themselves.
We've been in the studio solid kind of from the end of the tour, really. It's been about 2.5 months now, I think.
It's cosy.
Now we're at the stage really where we're still writing, but we're starting to record stuff at the same time. And this is where I've wanted to be the whole time.
Not bad, Aaron. That's cool, thank you.
We kind of found the direction quite early on that we wanted to go in.
Go again from the top, please.
And then we've just been heading that way ever since, and the songs have been getting better and better. Run For Your Life, it was sent to us a little while ago by Gary Barlow. I've been trying to write that song for a long, long time. It's basically saying how useless you are, but not in layman's terms. It's a really clever way of saying something that I've been trying to say for a long time.
Yeah, just
the last chorus onwards, please.
All For Nothing. We just wanted to write a track. We kind of were referencing some songs that we thought were the way we were listening to Trouble by Ray LaMontagne and When a Man Loves a Woman. You know, that vibe. You know, when you're in love with someone or something or anyone, you know, if you have a kid and something like that, it's like, it's the biggest blessing ever. But, and that's the thing, with the blessing comes the worry. Like, you've been blessed with that person, but then it's like, well, I feel that way, and that's, you know, I want you to stick around. So that's where we went with that one. I saw her body broke, still and cold where she lay, and it was all for nothing, this love I gave. It's always nice to think, try and get what you're writing about solid in your mind before you start picking up guitar. Once you get that, it's quite easy to feed off that thing that you thought of.
I wouldn't mind hearing a shorter version.
Let's do it.
Yeah, do that.
Today I'm working with James Walsh and Elliot James. I know James obviously from Star Sailor, massive Star Sailor fan, so it's been such a privilege to be able to work with him.
Should we just pile in like 4 more takes?
Yeah.
Sounding really good, man.
Thanks, buddy.
It's where I like being the most. It's in the studio recording stuff, you know. Oh, there's a lot of expectation and a lot of pressure that I'm putting on myself, and I think we've got a great record, and I just want people to like it as much as I do.
1, 2, 1, 2. Can I get some more track, please? Hearts are racing at the speed of light.
Eyes are opening and rolling right. Sinking feet.
Starlight was the second one we wrote with Biff and the gang, and we knew as soon as we'd written it that we had something really kind of special. Not really beginner's luck, because we'd all been doing it for years. We can't get one of the tracks that's going to be on the album second song in, surely not. And so we kind of just ignored it, and it's been there sort of brewing the whole time. We all listened to it back and we're like, you know what, that's worthy. Co-writing's brilliant. I absolutely love it. It took a little while to get used to, but then just got right into the swing of it. But I've been writing with some amazing songwriters, and that's been, you know, just an amazing experience. It's not far off what I was doing before. There's some like kind of rocky songs. There's some really soulful stuff. There's some stuff that couldn't get any more stripped back unless you just did it completely a cappella. You know, there's just like a piano in there, or a piano and acoustic. And yeah, this is where I want to be.